All these diamonds all up in my teeth, man. You don't know my struggle, what I had to do to get it, man. Now I'm in the gym, I'm a strong man. Now I'm in the gym, I'm a strong man. Now I'm in the gym.
Hey, man, it's same, man. It's your boy, not a first boogie, man. I'm fresh off work. And I'm coming to you with a reaction video to Young and Ace Through the Pain documentary. Came out about a couple hours ago. If I'm not mistaken, and I'm here to react to it, you hear me? Let's get to it. Excuse me. Make sure you like, share, comment, subscribe, and hit that post notification button over there. Let's get it. Oh yeah, I already seen a little trailer to it. Came out about a couple weeks ago. Let's get into this though. I'm pretty sure most of y'all seen it too.
It's almost some shit. I'm like, all right.
Jacksonville police have arrested
that was not a real life.
Victim of the quadruple shooting.
Like, here it was.
The local rapper who survived a shooting near the St. John's Town Center.
Talking about the shooting that happened last year on the 6th of June. Audrey Quanquan and folks. That's what they're talking about if you don't know.
Earlier this week,
you know, they take my hand, I drop my phone.
And behind bars.
I just blink out.
And he had no gun on him that night.
I'm like, brother, I got you. Just open the door.
Shit, live for the day, shit, we might die tomorrow.
Life on the line, I'll die for you, you're gonna die for me.
You've been dealing for so much, it's like you get used to that shit.
You gotta be you gotta be more than a soldier to make it through that.
Unfortunately, due to the travel restrictions of his probation, Young Ace was unable to travel to his hometown, Jacksonville, Florida. Excuse me. Determined to tell his story, we were accompanied by friends and family to Ace, former neighbor, allowing us to get a glimpse into his upbringing and life. My mud brother, my blood mother, all in one.
Yeah, this is trenches. It cut right here. You either walk through this cut to another neighborhood back there. Shit.
Bad.
We run through the cut, running from the police, jumping out of the car, run through the neighborhood. This is a little cut, but the police done closed it up.
Oh, he was a good child. He used to run around with his diaper on.
Mama.
He had long hair. The only place he liked to really stay is under me. Me and Trayvon.
She my best friend. I know nobody got me, she got me. Wrong or right, she gonna ride in the car with me till the wheels fall off. You know what I'm saying? We ain't never had nothing. I got 7 brothers on my mama's side. And like, we grew up with no daddy. My dad was doing 15 years in prison. My other brother's daddy, their daddy was in prison too. Plenty nights when he eat, plenty nights when he sleep. You know what I'm saying? My little brothers,
they
ain't really know as
know
much
that
until
track.
Like they got like to a certain age. They knew, but they ain't know for real.
We in Melissa right now, little apartments and shit. You know what I'm saying?
West side, zone 4 shit. Duval County, you know what I'm saying?
This the north side, that's where I record at, 33209. A lot of people ain't make around here. But I say it out of the way, say it in my lane.
5020 Cleveland apartment right down the street from here. Me hit big brothers, all of we played football together. My brother bought around, bike round, you know. We built a relationship like that. But you know, Ace, he called me big brother. You know, I feed him knowledge, let him know what's real. You know, that's my little homie though.
I met Ace like, what, my 9th grade year?
Yeah. Okay, so y'all took out that reaction video.
We had to move here, then we had to move there. House got shot up, so we had to move from out of there. Went to Clay County. I wish we did went to Clay County, because I don't like them.
So we in the trenches for real.
They go my granddaddy and they go AJ them right there.
With the
trenches for real. Huh? Interview. and my auntie. We on the corner store right here.
Yeah,
I'm out of my office, you
tripping.
Yo, I don't
know if y'all got permission to
come in the store and all that.
We can film in the store?
No. You
gotta ask the store owner.
Nah, we good.
I've been going by this store since I was.
You can't get shit free out of this store. My auntie on this bitch. For real. You gotta pay for everything. You can't trust nobody. It's Jacksonville. You can't trust your own blood. Shit.
Right now, anything can go down around this motherfucker. You know what I'm saying?
Like, for the day, shit, we might die tomorrow.
You gotta be on point out here.
In the bed, church, well, nigga ain't never like.
We got smoke with the whole city, so shit. You never know when, you know what I'm saying? Most definitely, you ain't gonna catch us down bad.
You know what I'm saying? There's killers everywhere, all around the city. But they love me, because I don't play the middleman.
You got a belly out of that?
I could fuck a bitch up and go back to Mayweather. Find me. Oh, yeah.
You pound.
See, there we go. It's out here, Jacksonville.
She ugly? Me?
Shabazz Shab. He on fire and he 904. He like to pay poker and he on fire. His whole arm, my son. Dice. Yeah, I'll make you laugh, I'll make you cry.
Shit. You get that call, your dog gone, your people gone, shit. But you've been dealing for so much, it's like you get used to that shit.
Like, oh, so-and-so just got shot. And like, oh, for real? That shit normal, man.
What you telling?
First song I made, I was 14 years old. I was at Melbourne Park on the bench. The park got a basketball court, Lil Pond and shit. First song was called Stop Stalking. I was already going through shit, feel what I'm saying? But like, me going through shit, that's how I vent to people. Like, I don't be wanting to talk. When you put them headphones in or put them on the speaker, you gonna feel like you dealt with me. Like, damn.
I just heard them in the room singing a song, you don't wanna go to war with me. And they asked me, like, could we do a video here? And I told them no.
Go to War. That was my first video I ever shot.
First video I seen on with that Go to War. I knew he was gonna be something, even when I first met him.
See, we always joke about how we gonna make it and all this shit. That's back then, you feel what I'm saying? And Trey's like, we gotta turn up on that bitch, you hear me? So, next thing we'll go through beats, boom, boom. Then just that beat just hit me, boom. I'm like, fuck a nigga. Nigga don't wanna go to war with us. Like, a nigga don't wanna go to war with me. I'ma die about me. You hear me? So I'm on that. Don't wanna go to war.
No, we gon' spoil it for you. When this fashion business, we don't wanna go to war with me. Mama crying, niggas dying, whatever. When you come in the mood, wanna go to war with me.
Showed me the video, and I said, why do y'all did that video in my house? And I told y'all, don't do it. Just getting police just coming through my doors, coming. They thought we had guns, but it wasn't no guns.
Hell yeah, that's why I went to jail. Police came kicking through shit, SWAT teams and shit, tank trucks, all that type of shit, kicked that bitch in. Thinking they finna go find all this crazy ass shit that they mix up together and think they finna come find, you know what I'm saying? But it was nothing like that. I'm always three steps ahead of people, you know what I'm saying? I'm always three steps ahead.
Fuck three, be six. Show me. On October 7th, 2018, I traveled to Fort Myers, Florida to speak to a group of kids in the regional juvenile detention center. I remember him posting that on Instagram. Had him a little blue. Or a little bit after he got out. It's like a striped shirt, white and blue. I'm black. I remember it, bitch. Yeah, I'm dropping.
Yeah, man, good vibes today, you know what I'm saying? We can go to the detention center, man. I'm going to talk to the kids and shit. I remember when I was younger, a nigga couldn't tell me nothing, you heard me, so shit. I already know how these niggas feel, shit. You know, these little niggas, shit. They really ain't got no choice.
They gonna listen.
But this is the thing, though. Like, sometimes you ain't got no choice. They chose life.
Arrived.
Came out a bit to come see all y'all, boy. I'm chilling. Yeah. I'm on this thing right here, though. I'm on this community control shit, you feel me? So it's like, I can't really do much. I can't go to the store if I want to. All my shit, I got to plan my schedule out by weekly. We come from the trenches, you feel me? Yeah. So a lot of them, they won't understand where we come from. You feel what I'm saying? We ain't choose this life. That shit, this high shit play out, you feel me? You don't want to be in this bit all your life. There's a lot of niggas in that bit facing life. 45 years. You know what I'm saying? One was doing 35. All of a sudden, he ain't have to. You feel what I'm saying? All that time, that's when everybody leave. You know what I'm saying? Everybody love you. When out that bitch doing that gangster shit, everybody want to jump in that stolo with you. You feel what I'm saying? But when the police come get you, all them niggas up. You feel what I'm saying? All that. All right, yo. After the incident when my brother them got shot, well, I got shot too. I got shot 8 times.
Earlier that year, on June 5th, 2018, at approximately the time we got off, because my camera right there, excuse me, he found himself at the center of a quadruple drive-by shooting that took place near Town Center Park where Jacksonville, Florida. Ace was shot 8 times. He was the only survivor. 2 other victims were pronounced dead at the scene. 1 died at the local hospital. True story. RJ. Quan, 2 times, 4. I was going to pull it.
The night before, 23, birthday was coming up. Everybody out here, they got numbers they go by. Every time I think of C4, I think 4. Every time I think 23, I think 23. You know what I'm saying? Quan's 2. I go in the room, I go jump on him and say, like, 23, nigga, happy birthday, nigga. I say, what's up, bro? He say, shit, I ain't supposed to make it to this day. What? My tattoo? Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm all the brothers, though. They all the way gangsta. Oh, yeah. Y'all seen it? Oh, yeah, that's all the way. That would, but look, though, in these streets, that would come with it. Y'all know that. That would come with it. That way, y'all gotta watch everything y'all do. Watch every move, feel what I'm saying? They say it's a reason, so they say God do everything for a reason, feel what I'm saying? He put his toughest soldiers through the toughest battles. I mean, I live for the day I might die tomorrow. We gotta go out and eat. I'm on my phone and shit. I'm trying to find out where the fuck my girlfriend at, cause she was eating too. So I'm trying to find out where the fuck she at. I'm about to go with her. Cause 23. And Quan, they trying to go with some hoes there. You feel what I'm saying? So I'm on some shit. I'm like, alright, listen, we stopped at a red light. What you heard was that. And when that bitch hit my hand, I dropped my phone. I heard 23, he was on the side of me. I heard him, he screaming and shit, so. I'm gonna die for you. You gonna die for me. Life on the line. I jump over the shield. I'm like, little brother, I got you. Just open the door. Open the door. When shit serious, he called by my real name. He's like, Kente, I can't move. Kente, I can't move. Kente, I can't move. Like, just hearing that, I can't move. That shit just fucked my mind up. Like, that shit played through my shit all day. Can't say I can't move. Can't say I can't move. You know what I'm saying? Ace, call ambulance. By the time I look back around, there's already people surrounding me. So I said, what shit happened? Call my girlfriend and shit.
After that, we go to the ambulance come with one car. Keep in mind, I ain't even look at my little brother. Still to the day, I ain't look at my little brother. He laying down on four lap. They came, they grabbed 23 first. He left. Another one came, they came and got me. Me and 23 outside the car. I'm laying down. Wow. Me and 23 on the ground and shit. This is before they came and got him. I'm laying down, but I'm calling out for him. I'm reaching for him. I'm like 23. But he not answering back to me. I'm like 23. I'm reaching out to him though. RJ, Royale, I'm calling about everything. You feel me? He ain't never answer. So I just close my eyes and say, I'm finna faint. I say, I'm about to die. And I'm like, they killed my brother. And this before I even knew anyone was dead. I said, they killed my brother. I just had a feeling. So we get to the ambulance. All that shit, Cobo's on the next door to me. They brought him back to life four times. He forever four. Everything happened with me four times. They brought him back to life four times. I was in the hospital bed. They told me, the doctor told me I was finna die. I told him to keep 100. You think I'ma live? He said, I don't know, it might be. I said, keep 100. Do you think I'm gonna live? He said, it's too many holes. Like, I don't think you're gonna make it. Feel what I'm saying?
Having receiving proper hospital care, Ace was arrested by Jacksonville Sheriff's Department for violating his probation and quickly transported to jail with 8 bullets still inside of him. Upon his release, he was sentenced to 9 months of house arrest.
My name is David Haas. I was Ace's lawyer. I've been a lawyer for 17 years. I spent 5 years as a state prosecutor. I spent 10 years as a federal prosecutor. And now I have my own criminal defense practice here in Orlando, Florida. The first time I met with Ace was in Jacksonville. His hand was heavily wrapped. He'd been shot. And I could tell he was in a lot of pain, but he wasn't complaining. And really, that's when I went to work. It was pretty much around the clock. Trying to get in touch with the sheriff's office, trying to get in touch with the state attorney's office to get the best possible outcome that we could.
Breaking overnight, Jacksonville police have arrested the only surviving victim of the quadruple shooting.
Deadly shooting on the city's south side leaves 3 people dead.
Keontae Bullard, also known as Young and Ace,
is now out of the hospital and behind bars. His younger brother and 2 friends died in that same drive-by shooting.
He's on GPS monitoring right now, and he has a curfew from 10 p.m. until 6 a.m. His attorney also told us that their priority at this point is to get him to the hospital because he still has 8 bullets in him, including in his hand, his leg, and his arm. He and his attorney gave a brief statement.
Do you feel safe?
I'm good.
He's in our care. I said we have a grooming standard in our jail that your hair.
Hair
has to be neat and clean. And I said, that's not neat and clean. You know, someone says, oh, you might have violated his rights. No, I didn't violate. He's in my care. And in my care, you will look neat and clean.
Shaving his head for no reason, putting it under the guise of that's how we clean you up.
It was fucked up, basically, because he was shot up. Brother just got killed.
He had been shot 8 times, and I believe at that point we had 3 or 4 or 8 bullets inside of him still. Considering he really needed to go to a hospital. Because he didn't have insurance, the hospital wouldn't take the bullets out of him. So while he was in custody, it was really became that part, it was the responsibility of the sheriff's office to make sure he got the medical care he needed. Sheriff's office didn't give him medical care, they didn't give him antibiotics, and they basically just left him in there.
My mind was all fucked up. I was really feeling like, fuck that. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm feeling spasm in this bitch. Like, I'm all fucked up. I'm limping. I barely can walk. I can't really sit down. I can't really sleep. I'm on this hard-ass cell bed. Like, I barely can eat. My mind ain't functioning right.